In today's video, we will be having a look on this tiny FPGA board, and we'll see how we can upload a basic program in it. So this is what you get inside. It's just a USB cable, some header pins, and this is the board itself. Okay. This is the USB pin here. And you just only need a USB cable, USB type C, to program this device. In the center you have the USB, and on the right this is the full-size HDMI. Okay, on the back side you have the SD card and a huge logo that says Tank 9K. The specifications I'll be showing you just in a minute. Okay, so let's get started. How to program this FPGA? So it has a onboard GTEC FPGA programmer and a UART as well, and a rest of the specifications you can see in here. You can just connect the USB and plug it into your PC, and with the help of the software setup, we can download the program straight away into this board. We have some other things on this FPGA as well, like this one is the FPGA itself. We have RGB connector here, HDMI connector in here. We have SPI flash memory, crystal 27 megahertz, SPI 3 volt converter, and JTAG and UART programmer, and USB type C in here. So in order to program this, we need a couple of softwares and other plugins to program this one. So first of all, thing that we need, Visual Studio Code, VS Code. You have to download this software. It's free for the Windows, and you can just download this one. It's easy, just you have to follow the prompts, and after installation you would see something like this one. First thing that we need to do is go after the status bar in here, which is at the bottom. So to view that status bar, I'll go to the view and appearance and status bar. This is a purple status bar. So when nothing is installed and VS Code is freshly installed, you won't see these things. FPGA toolchain and auto detect thing. It will be blank. So to get these things, we have to do a couple of plugin installations. So to install the plugins, we need to go to this extension thing, and these are the plugins that we want to install. Okay, this is the major plugin, Lucia's Code, and you can just type in here, and you then press the install button. The link to the Lucia's Code plugin is here. So if you have installed this VS Code, and if you click this button, you will see this prompt, and you can open the Visual Studio, and you will straight away get into this screen, and you can then install it. So I have already installed, that's why I don't see any button. Okay, so once it is installed, you can click on this gear or the manage extension thing and go to the extension settings. Okay, in here, so when this is freshly installed, you will also be getting a prompt down the bottom in here that you want to set the path. This will be empty. So here you have to give the path to this bin folder, and this this specific folder contains the toolchain kit. It is called the OSS CAD suite build. Okay, on GitHub. I'll put the link in the descriptions, all the links in the description as well. So this is, you would wanna download this one, and it's a it's almost 70 megabytes. So once you download this one, unzip it. It's an executable thing. When you will just unzip it, you will have something like this one. Okay, all these files in here. This one's all you want to know is this bin folder. This bin folder, you open it up and you copy this path, and this path needs to be here. Here there's a very important point that the name of this folder must not contain any weird characters or any spaces. If there's any space in this path, the final compilation will not work. Okay, so once you set this path correctly, you would see that you will have this simple thing in here. So this is the FPGA toolchain thing, and when you will make a project, it will give you an option to build and program your FPGA board. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it. One last thing that you may want to do is usage of this USB driver installation. So it's preferred that when you plug in your board, FPGA board, you will have an option here. So let me plug in my board and I'll show you. So here you need to go to the list all devices. Yeah, so now you don't see any device, but when I plug in my FPGA board, you would see that you have JTAG debugger interface 1 and JTAG debugger interface 0. So interface 1 is for the UART, for the serial communication. For the JTAG 0, this is the where the programming happens. Okay, so you need to select this one, and you need to select this one, and you have to replace this with the WinUSB driver. Okay, this one, like this. So the driver installation was successful, and this should be it. Okay, because the default drivers might not work with the process that we are using. We are using this tool chain, so in here it requires this sort of a driver to work with. Okay, so that's it, and now we are ready to go to the screen and you start the coding. Okay, so to start the coding, we can go to the new file in here, type in the, we are just trying the code counter one at v. We'll write, I made a new folder. It's good because it generates a lot of other files. So it's better to make a new project folder. So this is the folder, and to get the code, I'll copy this whole code. So this is a very long programming. Let me go through it quickly. We start with the module top, and we have the input clock, and we have the output LEDs. We don't know what is the clock or clock pin is. We don't know what are the LEDs, but we just define it. Okay, we just define and write a program for it. So basically the FPGA programming needs at least two files. One is this programming file, and other one is the constraints file, where we define that what are the actual hardware connections for these variables, whatever we are using in here. Okay, so we also define the local parameter. This value, it has been calculated that 30 million cycles are required to wait for a half a second. So basically we'll be making a LED counter program that will be counting a number in the binary format, and the increments will happen every half a second. So with this FPGA board, this 30 million after 30 million cycles, it is it's like a half a second. Okay, so we also define a LED counter register. This is MSB, this is the LSB, so 0 to 5, it's like 6 bits. And this is a LED clock counter, which will be counting these cycles. So because this number is big, these number of cycles that we have to wait for, so we need 24 bits in here. And always, it's like what we do always for this FPGA is like a positive edge. And positive edge of this clock. Okay, we begin the code and we increment the clock counter, this variable, every time we detect a positive edge of the at the clock pin. Okay, and please note that this is not the regular C++ less than or equal to sign. This is assignment operator in the Verilog, and to know more about it, you can go to the Google and write it here, open this Verilog. Okay, so you can have an idea that it's a non-blocking assignment and what's the difference between the just equal to and just and this one. Okay, so yeah, if the wait time becomes equal to the clock counter, we just increment the LED by one. Okay, and reset the clock counter. And lastly, we just assign the LED, the register here output, with the LED counter, that would be a binary number, and we end the module. Okay, we just copy this whole thing and go to the VS Code. I'll just paste it and make sure that I save it. Okay, I've saved this file, and another file that I want to use. Okay, same, and I'll make a new file now. A new file is called counter1.cst. Okay. This is the constraints file, and it defines the relation between the all the software and the hardware pins in the FPGA. Okay. So because we have installed this Lucius code plugin, it has a capability to automatically detect that the CSD file, the constraints file, and it needs to have some sort of a different menu in here. Okay, so either you can add a constant on your own, or you can just select a correct FPGA. Mine one is like a Tango 9K, and I'll add from the template. I'm using the clock pin, I'm using the LEDs that are on the board. Okay, I'm not using anything else. So add the constraints. So you can see that all the five LEDs have these five these locations in here, and the hardware locations. Okay, and these things are also available in the schematics and rest of this stuff. So it's a bit of exploration to find out these. So for now, we just give it a template. Okay, and yeah, if you see a dot in here, it means it's not saved. So let's save it. This dot is gone. This is good. So that's basically it. The program is ready. I'll just select the Verilog code and go to the FPGA toolchain kit and go to the built-in program or build only or program only. I'll just built-in program. Okay, it will do its thing. First it's a synthesis and then the place and route PNR for this device. Okay, finished peering now. Okay, it is a problem. Unable to find FTDI device. We have the bit stream as well. Okay. So again, it's a problem with the USB driver. So let's do it again. We have interface 0. Reinstall the driver. Let's see if it works. So driver has been installed, and let's program only. Okay, so it has been programmed.
And this is how it looks like. You can see that the counting is not understandable. That's because, yeah, it starts from all LEDs on. So the LED that is off is one that's active. Okay, so what we need to do is that invert the LEDs so that whichever the LED is on, that indicates the binary value. So now it should be other way. Now it's good. So whatever LED is on, you can see that that is the bit representation of 1, and that's how it counts, okay, in the binary. So the new program is now uploaded. You can see it's still counting in binary. It's a bit faster.